My name is Abhishek Krishnan. I head the marketing team for Radeon Technologies Group India, and we are gathered here because we have access to Vega 56 and 64, and we're going to be benchmarking it against the 1070, especially the Vega 56. We have called the best industry experts today at Taj Lands End, and they're going to take this forward. So I have with me Shatul, Amey, Mr. Rakesh, as well as the Gaming Central team, and last not the least, Pratyush from Indian Noob. So they're going to be taking this forward and kind of talking about what their experience was with the entire benchmarking and the review process. So off to Shatul from here.
Hi guys, my name is Shatul and I'm from Toolius Tech. We've actually spent the last 48 hours benching Vega. So we've had 48 hours with Vega now, and we've learned a lot of really interesting things. One of them is that we have, let me just get this out of the way, we have a new mainstream king. It just depends on the pricing right now, what the final Indian price is, but if we're close to the 1070, then there's no reason to buy a 1070 anymore. Let me just put it to you this way, you know, it's the cat's out of the bag. Now, several interesting things that we actually noticed benching with Vega over the last 48 hours was that A, it's a very consistent performer. We're actually seeing much lesser frame rate drops and much lesser frame rate fluctuations from Vega versus Nvidia. We're testing them on, identical machines. So the machines were built by me and my friend Amey from G-Tech and Toolius Tech. So we built the machines, there's no hanky-panky, there's no special tweaks or special BIOSes or special hardware or any of that stuff here. It's just absolutely the same systems, 1800Xs, Crosshair 6-0s, right down to even the same cooler. So literally the same systems. We've got 4266 memory from G-Skill running at 3200. We've got 1800X running at 4 GHz, Crosshair 6-0, and it's and it's liquid cool. The only difference is that we have a Galax 1070 in this machine, and we have a stock Radeon Vega 56 here. So it's basically the normal, not even overclock, not even an AIB card, or not even something that's, you know, like by Asus or something. This is just stock reference design, and it's actually a dev board, so you can expect a lot more performance from drivers and, like, you know, AIB boards when they come around. So the signs are extremely positive for this card. It's been beating the 1070 by almost 20 to 25% in certain tests, 15-20% in most tests, and as high as even 25 and 30% in some tests. So consistent victories. It's not a fluke. It's literally every single test we throw at it, you name it, 3D Mark, Firestrike, Time Spy, 3D Mark 11, all the games, Doom, Prey, you know, Battlefield 1. We've tested a lot, and consistent wins.
We have specifically been testing the RX Vega 56 since past 2 days, and it has been pitched against the 1070, and from what we have been seeing in gaming as well as synthetic benchmarks, the performance has been really promising. We have been experiencing at least 10 to 15% performance boost over the 1070. In certain cases, it's almost 20%. And hoping that the Indian pricing is in line with what the dollar pricing is in the US, I think we have a new king in the mainstream segment.
मैं राकेश शर्मा मोडर हूँ, थोड़ा बहुत मोडिंग करता हूँ, कुछ थोड़ा बहुत पीसी के बारे में जानता हूँ, लेकिन अभी आज वेगा का मैंने फर्स्ट व्यू देखा, कार्ड के बारे में देखा, बहुत वेगा 56 था नेट पे पहले पढ़ा था काफ़ी बारे में, कुछ रूमर्स थे कि परफॉर्मेंस 1070 के बराबर आएगा, उससे नीचे आएगा, उससे ऊपर आएगा, कुछ आइडिया नहीं था, लेकिन अभी कार्ड को देखा तो रॉ परफॉर्मेंस तो 1070 इज उसके आसपास भी नहीं आता है. जबरदस्त परफॉर्मेंस तो ठीक है, वह काफ़ी अच्छा है. अब देखते हैं AMD इसको प्राइस कैसा लेकर आता है, सबसे बड़ा पॉइंट यही है. चाहे सिंथेटिक बेंचमार्क हो, चाहे गेम प्ले हो, फ्रेम रेट्स हो, सब कुछ, सब में इट इज़ फार फार फॉरवर्ड देन 1070.
फ्रॉम वॉट आई हैव सीन इन द पास्ट 2 days, द वेगा 56 बीट्स द 1070 बाय क्वाइट सम मार्जिन, and is also more consistent in terms of performance, I mean in terms of FPS. So while it does have a 20 to 30% average increase, it's also a more consistent, more fluid performance than the GTX 1070, which drops down to considerably.
So we've been here for 2 days, testing the Vega 56 against the 1070 on two identical systems, and we have managed to test four games so far: Doom, Prey, Witcher 3, and Battlefield 1. In most cases, we've seen a 10% performance increase over the 1070, and in case of Doom, it's way more than that, around 20%. And in synthetics as well, we see a 20% to 30% increase in scores.
Hey guys, Shrey from Gaming Central. And so this is sort of a first of a kind enthusiast meet where tech enthusiasts are coming together to test out AMD's latest Vega series of GPUs. And it's been fun actually. The last 2 days has been fun because we've built in a couple of systems which are actually the same, the difference being the GPU 1070 versus the Vega 56, and the performance actually has been pretty good. It's been very consistent, and it's been between 15 to 20% performance hike in games, a consistent hike between in games. We've tested a mix of four games: Doom, Battlefield, Witcher, and Prey. And of course, a more detailed benchmarking and all of that would be available on Gaming Central's site as well. So yeah, I mean, in general, it's been pretty good. And a thumbs up to Vega.
As far as I'm concerned, we do have a new mainstream king. We have a card that can finally dethrone the 1070. It's just about what our Indian cost is. But yeah, in terms of hardware, in terms of performance, it's an absolutely a win. There is no doubt in my mind that this is a faster card. So kudos to AMD. Thank you for having us and giving us the chance to spend 48 hours with Vega. I'm hoping to flick one of these cards. Not really, just kidding. But yeah, I mean, it just, I just the fact that, I mean, I said that means I just want to spend a lot of time with this card. Even in overclocking, as my friend Amay mentioned, we're hitting 150 plus megahertz on stock voltages. We're hitting almost 950 to 1000 megahertz on the memory controller. So for early BIOSes, no support, no applications, no nothing, still, yeah, it's doing this. That's mighty impressive. Mighty, mighty impressive. You'll see much more data very soon on Toolius Tech as well, and I'm sure with Gaming Central as well. But we've already got the benchmarks and expect a write-up and a video very, very soon on Toolius Tech as well. So yeah, thanks for joining us, and thank you AMD for giving us a chance to play with this hardware. It's truly a dream come true. Thank you guys.